Hi everybody. Last year in the VC we had a thread going on the final hype. Is it a good thing or is it a bad thing? And during that discussion we mainly focused on the final itself. But something else was happening. Something great was happening because of the final hype. Manufacturers of turntables were introducing new models. And last year even Technics announced that they will reintroduce the SL1200. The 1200. The 1200, the 12 with the two zeros is back. The legend is back. I want to review it, go quickly over the new features and go into more detail how it sounds, how it feels and how it looks. So the first thing you will notice is the breastplate on top of the platter. This is to increase the weight of the platter, which is now almost 7 pounds or a little over. Underneath there is rubber. Together with the brass plates, this helps dampening of the vibrations. You see also three screws. This is where the platter is mounted to the motor. The motor is, of course, it's Technics, it's direct drive, but they redesigned it completely. They have taken away the iron from the coils and introduced a second rotor. So there's a rotor on top and at the bottom of the coils, which increases the torque, which they lost because of removing the iron. And I think also the magnets help to take a little bit of load off the bearing, and I think maybe the electronics in the coils heat up also a little bit the oil in the bearing. You see those two holes? With that you can change or you can reach the settings for the brake torque and the startup torque. Depending how you use the turntable, I think it will be beneficial if you change that from standard setting. But I will discuss that in a separate video. Then you have the tone arm, and the tone arm really is a special story in itself, which makes this turntable even more unique. When they were designing it, they had trouble engineering the tone arm, and they found out that they no longer had the knowledge in the company to do this. So what they did is they went back to the old people from the special projects who developed this tone arm in the 70s. So they got in touch with those engineers who were now already in their 70s, one was even in his 90s, and together with the young engineers which were working on the table, together they made this new tone arm. And I mean, that's amazing. It's so great that the history of the Technics, the 50 years they are making turntables, all got together and they created this table. So you have really the DNA of Technics in this table. You have that also a little bit with the plinth. So the outside of the plinth is made of rubber. And this is done in this exactly the same press as all the 3 million something Technics have been made, there's up 1200. It's four layers, so you have the rubber on the outside, then you have some fiber enforced material, polyester, for the second layer, then you have the metal skin where everything is attached to, and then you have this beautiful one piece aluminium, which is the top, which is very beautiful and I think also very heavy. But that gives the whole table its rigidity. So the whole table is almost 40 pounds. Most important, how does it sound? Well, the first thing for me and the most important thing is, does it have rhythm and pace? And usually to check that, I take my favorite album from the Crusaders, Jazz Funk. If it can play jazz and funk at the same time and I'm bopping my head, tapping my feet, I know it's good. And with this table, I must say, it was immediately clear it can play this kind of music perfectly. But what you will notice first when you start it up is the sound stage. The sound stage is like boom, it's there, it's rock solid and it won't move. The images it plays are very defined and focused. So if you change the music to some jazz trio, for example Michael DiMarco, then it is really very well defined and focused and organized, so that it grabs your attention. It's fun to listen to the music. But you can also go completely the other way, and then you will have the real sound of an SL1200. Play some Prodigy and the energy will pop out of your speakers. Then the whole frequency range, but especially what surprised me was the lower range is really so well defined, and I don't know if the ultra low, my system does not go that low, but just the bass, the kick drum, it is really fantastic the way that is recreated from the Black Vinyl. And I think because of the vibration dampening and the direct drive, you get very well balanced music. The sound stage is wide, it's not super wide, and the images are there, but they're also not extremely big, but it all sounds very balanced and very natural. I did all my listening with the DL103R, which is built into a wooden body. I must say the synergy between this cartridge and this table is perfect. They're really made for each other. I'm sure there are other cartridges which will also fit this table very well, but the characteristics of this cartridge together with this arm and the table, it worked very well. On the other hand, I did not change anything. It's almost completely standard how I played it. So standard is this mat, rubber mat, which I used. I used not the cables, the RCA cables, so you can change them. I used some copper wiring and the head shell, where I used the standard head shell that was delivered with the unit. That's one of the surprising things. If you look at any SL1200 that has ever been made, the head shell will say at the top, Technics. And for some reason, my unit is delivered, and what I have seen on all the pictures, it does not say Technics at the top, so I bought a spare one. I think an SL1200 should have a head shell which shows Technics, but I don't know the reason why they changed that. And you will see some really standard 1200 components in this unit. So for example, the start-stop button, it's exactly the same one. I think they have bought loads and loads of spare parts of this. Let me double check. So also the arm lift is also like standard 1200. I must say this is a little bit of pity because this piece, the arm lift, this is plastic. And they should have made that also from metal, I think. But then you have, of course, the complete look. If you go to the looks, it's a classic 1200 look. And the form follows the function. And that is just what I wanted. I'm very, very happy that they used this layout. This is made to play vinyl. This is made in a way that it is the most easy way to play vinyl. If you want to change speed, you press the button, you change it. You can even change the head shell. If you want to have a mono recording or you want to use a different cartridge, it's easy to change. I find myself now when I'm changing the side of the album, I first stop it, take it off, turn it around and start it up again. It's really easy to use. This layout of everything makes it very easy to do. Also the setting of the arm, the anti-bias, the VTA, it all follows itself. Other things which are typical, of course, of the Technics 1200 is a stroboscope here on this side, the on-off button. The pop-up light is also there, of course. It's all there to make it fun to play vinyl. And everything you touch, you feel the quality. The craftsmanship that has been put in this table is amazing. The pitch fader also, although it is now more digitally controlled, it feels very solid. I'm no DJ. Do I use the pitch fader? Yes. If, for example, if I'm in the mood to play 12 inches, Chic for example, then it is fun to just increase it a little bit, like half a percent, 1%, speed it up, and it just, for some reason, it will sound just right. Then, of course, the biggest thing, and which has been a big discussion when it was introduced, the price. What do you get for the money? I think, personally, the value for money on this table is incredible. The engineering on this table is amazing. You really feel with everything that you inherit, the technology or the DNA that Technics had, it's built up in 50 years, it's all in this one table. Everything they know, it's here. It plays beautiful music with really a rock solid background. It is very well balanced, and I must say, it is built. It is built like a tank. In short, the legend is back, and I'm very happy with this unit. Thank you for watching. See you next time.